It's weird. This is the thing with, like, haunted movies that always kind of bother me, which is the specter, the ghost, the thing that is doing the haunting, I feel like on some level, its only motivation is whatever is convenient for the scene. And Stephen King, even in his books, has never escaped this. Where, like, it's the curse of having to write horror fiction when you want to write about the people, is that the ghost shouldn't really matter, and the ghost is just a tool. And I like for the ghost to be a character, too. So, like, the thing with the room would be a lot more interesting, to me at least, if, like, we knew what was causing the haunting, or, like, why it felt the need to torture people, or why its creation is so ironic. Like, I don't fucking know. There was a psychiatrist who killed himself in there, and now he enjoys just fucking with people in their heads. Like, something, you know?
Hugo Strange lived here once.
Exactly that. Like, I don't know. The ghost is really random. I appreciate, like, the metaphor and the artistry of what's being done with the main character. I just kind of wish I knew why the ghost was doing it. Like, why does he care? And I think The Shining escapes this a little bit because, like, the hotel, everyone in it, like, it's its own personality. It's multifaceted. It's just there's so much happening in that place that it is kind of, like, quietly going mad. And in this, it's one room. And one room doesn't have the same sort of mysticism, I think, that the hotel does.
Yeah.
I don't know. Because I see where you're coming from, but at the same time, I think Samuel Jackson might have the best line in this movie, which is, oh, it's not a phantom or a ghost. It's a fucking evil room.
I do like that.